The following message is transmitted at the request of the Norfolk Police Department and the Norfolk Department of Public Health. At approximately 5 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the Norfolk Department of Public Health has detected an unknown virus that has been spreading throughout the city of Norfolk. It is believed that 100 to 200 cases of this unknown infection have been reported, and this number is likely to rise within the coming hours. Symptoms of this disease include nausea, vomiting, high fever, fatigue, sneezing, severe coughing, sore throat, headache, congestion, and body aches. There are more severe cases that occur in the elderly or young children, which can be shortness of breath, pneumonia, and possibly death if not treated properly. Methods of transmission, mortality rate, and incubation period have not been identified at this time. As a precaution, the Norfolk Department of Public Health are instituting new health guidelines that will be in effect for the city of Norfolk and will start immediately until further notice or until this virus has been successfully contained. These include washing your hands with soap and warm water for at least 20 seconds after touching the eyes or mouth or after going to the bathroom. Maintain a safe distance of at least 6 feet from others who are not in your household. Avoid touching your face, nose, eyes, or mouth. Frequently clean surfaces after use. Cover your cough or sneeze with a tissue, or into your arm. Avoid large gatherings. If you believe you are infected with this virus, you are advised to do the following instructions. Quarantine yourself in an isolated room for at least 7 to 10 days. Wear a facial covering such as a mask to prevent infecting others in your household, and maintain a safe distance between your loved ones. If one of your family members are experiencing severe complications associated with this virus, seek medical attention immediately. Hospitals across the city can approach full capacity, as cases of this virus can skyrocket, so take yourself to the hospital as soon as possible. If your local hospital is full, try to take yourself to a doctor's office for treatment. Tune into local media outlets for more information on this developing situation.
This is ABC 13 News, with a breaking story coming out of the city of Norfolk. The Norfolk Department of Public Health has detected an unknown virus that has been spreading throughout the city of Norfolk. It has been confirmed that 100 to 200 cases of this unknown virus have been reported, and this number is expected to skyrocket within the next coming hours. The incubation period, mortality rate, and methods of transmission are unknown at this time, but symptoms of this unknown virus have been identified. These include nausea, vomiting, headache, fatigue, high fever, chills, severe coughing, sneezing, congestion, and body aches. Severe cases that occur in the elderly, young children, and people with underlying medical conditions can cause shortness of breath and pneumonia, which can be fatal if not treated. Due to the spread of this unknown disease, the Norfolk Department of Public Health have instituted new health guidelines for the city of Norfolk, and will be in effect starting today until further notice, or until the virus has been successfully contained. These guidelines may be found on the site of the Norfolk Department of Public Health. We currently have a reporter live by Centauri Norfolk General Hospital, Aaron. Aaron, how is the situation going?
I'm currently live by Centauri Norfolk General Hospital, and things are starting to look bad as I speak. Cases of this unknown virus is rising, and the hospital is currently overflowing with patients with this virus, and this hospital could be full at any moment. This virus has originated out of nowhere, and it is unknown how it started. Like you said, the Norfolk Department of Public Health are now instituting new health guidelines for the city of Norfolk, and will remain in effect until further notice, starting today. These include washing your hands with soap and warm water for at least 20 seconds after touching the eyes or mouth, keeping a safe distance between others, avoid large gatherings, and if you are infected with the virus, quarantine yourself for at least 7 to 10 days and wear a mask to prevent your loved ones of being infected. It is likely that hospitals across the city of Norfolk will reach full capacity, so it's highly recommended to take yourself to the hospital as soon as possible if you believe you are infected with this virus. Back over to you, Evan.
Thank you, Aaron. We hope to provide you with more information about the virus whenever it becomes available. This is ABC 13 News, with a breaking story. We will now switch to your regularly scheduled programming.
The following message is transmitted at the request of the Norfolk Department of Public Health. The virus that has been spreading throughout the city of Norfolk has mutated and has gained new severe symptoms. These include blurred vision, dehydration, coughing or vomiting blood, dementia, difficulty breathing, insomnia, anxiety, and in some cases, changes in behavior. In addition, the mortality rate of this virus has also increased to 30%. There are now approximately 3,000 cases of this virus and have been reported in surrounding areas, including Hampton, Suffolk, Virginia Beach, Portsmouth, Chesapeake, and Pocosin. Hospitals across these cities previously mentioned are full at this time and are starting to not let more people in. Due to the mutation of the virus and cases continuing to rise within the coming hours, Mayor Kenny Alexander is instituting a stay-at-home order until further notice. You can only go outside for essential purposes, like going to work, exercising, going to grocery or convenience stores, and visiting family who may need assistance. Please do not leave your home for non-essential purposes, as this can put you and your family at high risk for contracting the virus. All non-essential businesses, such as restaurants, theaters, salons, spas, museums, shopping centers, bowling alleys, airports, sporting events, and concerts will be closed until further notice, or until this virus has been successfully contained. This also includes schools, and will begin instructions virtually. Restaurants and bars will only be open for takeout and delivery. If you need to leave your home, please make sure you do the following precautions: wear a mask or any other facial covering, as this virus is now airborne. Keep a safe 6-foot distance from others who are not in your family, due to this virus being capable of spreading through person to person. It is also highly advised you avoid any physical contact with others, such as high fives, fist bumps, dap ups, or hugs. If you or one of your loved ones is infected, quarantine for at least 7 to 10 days in an isolated room. Do not take them to the hospital, as all hospitals around these areas are full, and are not letting any more people in. Please stay tuned to this station for more information on this situation.
This is ABC 13 News, with another breaking story coming out of the city of Norfolk. We have just received an update about this new virus that has been spreading throughout the city of Norfolk for the past day. There have been reports of new symptoms coming in from patients with this virus. These include coughing or vomiting blood, blurred vision, dehydration, anxiety, insomnia, dementia, and in most cases, changes in behavior. The mortality rate of this virus has also increased to 30%. Cases of this virus have also ballooned to 3,000 and are now reported in surrounding areas. This definitely does not seem like a COVID-19 variant at all, as there are now new symptoms and increase in mortality rate with this virus. This could possibly be a whole new virus, much deadlier than COVID-19. Back to our news correspondent live at Centara Norfolk General Hospital, Aaron. Aaron, how does it look right now at this time?
I am still here by Centara Norfolk General Hospital, and things are not getting any better as I speak. The hospital has now reached full capacity and are now starting to not let more people in. This has also been reported in other hospitals in surrounding areas. Like you said, this is a completely different virus, and definitely does not seem like a COVID-19 variant at all, as this new virus now has gained a mutation and new severe symptoms, including an increase in the mortality rate. Due to more cases of this virus and the increase of the mortality rate, Mayor Kenny Alexander is now putting the entire city of Norfolk and surrounding areas at a stay-at-home order until further notice. You are only allowed to go outside for essential purposes, like going to work, exercising, and visiting family who may need assistance. All non-essential businesses are going to be closed until further notice, such as restaurants, salons, spas, museums, shopping centers, bowling alleys, sporting events, concerts, and more. Schools are also shut down, and will move instructions virtually. These may be strict guidelines, but they are well needed to prevent the virus from spreading further. I have to go, I can't risk being infected with this virus. This is Aaron, signing off.
Thank you, Aaron. This situation is definitely not getting any better as time goes on. If you live in Norfolk, please stay in your homes, as this puts you and your family at a low risk of contracting this virus. This is Evan, from ABC 13 News, and we will now switch you to your regularly scheduled programming.
The following message is transmitted at the request of the Norfolk Police Department. At approximately 8 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, there have been reports of mass rioting, looting, and civil unrest occurring throughout the city of Norfolk. People who have been participating in these riots are causing massive damage to property, injuries, fatalities, robberies, and even fires. There have also been reports of people hoarding essential supplies in grocery and convenience stores, such as food, drinks, medications, and more. The National Guard is currently on the scene to deal with this situation. Already, 25 arrests, 10 fatalities, and 50 serious injuries have been reported throughout the city of Norfolk due to these riots. This has also made the spread of this virus worse, as people were seen in large gatherings, not social distancing, and not wearing masks. At this time, all residents of the city of Norfolk are strongly advised to remain in your homes with all your windows and doors locked. Do not approach these rioters, as they are extremely dangerous, and some of the rioters have also been seen carrying firearms. If you are in an area that is subject to rioting, move away from the area immediately. If one or more of these riots enter your home, defend yourself at any means necessary. Do not participate in the riots. I repeat, do not participate in the riots. If you do so, you will be arrested and could face serious criminal charges. Tune into local media outlets for more information on this dangerous situation. The following message is transmitted at the request of the Norfolk Department of Public Health. At approximately 12 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the virus that has been spreading throughout the city of Norfolk has mutated again and has gained more new severe symptoms. These symptoms include hallucinations, seizures, delirium, confusion, psychosis, widening of the eyes and pupils, necrosis, coma, violent or aggressive behavior, and death due to total organ failure. In addition, the mortality rate of this virus is 100% if not treated properly. There have also been reports of doctors being attacked by the infected patients inside of the hospital. The virus has also spread to more surrounding areas, including Williamsburg, Elizabeth City, Hopewell, Petersburg, Chester, and Highland Springs. There is an estimated 10,000 cases of this virus and about 3,000 deaths being reported, with most of these deaths coming from total organ failure. Hospitals across these cities previously mentioned are at full capacity and are not allowing any more people in. Due to cases skyrocketing, the virus spreading even further, and reports of attacks from the infected patients inside hospitals, Mayor Kenny Alexander is advising all residents of the city of Norfolk, regardless of your current health status, to shelter in place at this time for the foreseeable future. You are not allowed to go outside for any reason, due to this virus being so contagious, deadly, and spreading at an increasing rate, and this would also put you at high risk of contracting the virus, and almost certainly facing death due to total organ failure. All non-essential businesses, even some essential businesses, are all going to be shut down until further notice. All restaurants and bars will only be open for delivery, and grocery stores will also be closed. If you need to leave your home, do so at your own risk, and it is highly recommended you wear a mask, avoid large crowds, avoid physical contact with others, and keep a safe distance from others who are not in your household. Proper hygiene rules, such as washing hands with soap and warm water for 20 seconds, avoid touching your eyes, nose, face, and mouth, and clean surfaces after use will still apply. If you or one of your family members is infected, or are experiencing violent or aggressive behavior, isolate them in a room, and do not take them to the hospital, as all hospital beds in every single hospital in Norfolk and surrounding areas are full, and are not accepting any more patients. Stay tuned to this station for more information on this dangerous situation.
This is ABC 13 News, and the situation with the virus that has been spreading throughout the city of Norfolk for the past 1 day and a half is continuing to get worse. We have received word that the virus has mutated again, with more symptoms being shown from the infected patients. These symptoms include hallucinations, seizures, delirium, confusion, psychosis, necrosis, violent or aggressive behavior, widening of the eyes and pupils, and possibly death due to total organ failure. The mortality rate of this virus is 100% if you don't get proper treatment. This virus has also spread to more surrounding areas, including Williamsburg, Elizabeth City, Hopewell, Petersburg, Chester, and Highland Springs. There are an estimated 10,000 cases of this virus and 3,000 deaths being reported, with most of these deaths coming from total organ failure. Hospitals across the city or Norfolk and surrounding areas are all full, and are not accepting patients at this time. This virus is continuing to get worse and more lethal as time goes on, and this could probably be a large-scale outbreak due to this virus being so contagious, deadly, and spreading at an increasing rate. Back at downtown Norfolk is Aaron. Aaron, how does it look right now?
I'm here in downtown Norfolk, and the situation is just never getting any better. The city is a complete ghost town due to most, if not all, businesses are closed until further notice. This virus is a virus we have never seen before, and has spread so quickly at an increasing rate with no signs of stopping. All hospitals across the city of Norfolk and surrounding areas are full, and are not allowing any more people in. We have also received reports of random and violent attacks to doctors, which are from the patients who are infected with the virus. I have also received word that one of the infected patients literally ate one of the doctor's entire hand. That doctor is currently having medical attention at this time. You won't believe when I say this, but I believe these infected patients are in fact zombies. I repeat, I believe these infected patients are in fact zombies. Due to this, Mayor Kenny Alexander is advising all residents of the city of Norfolk and surrounding areas, no matter what your current health status is, to shelter in place. You are not allowed to exit your home under any circumstances, as this can put you at high risk for contracting the virus, and almost certainly facing death due to the virus's mortality rate. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention are also not ruling out a potential pandemic with this new virus, as this virus is so contagious, deadly, and is spreading at an insanely increasing rate. If you are in Norfolk, please stay in your homes, as we could be for a rough day or week. I have to go, I can't risk being infected with this virus. This is Aaron, signing off once again.
Wow, I can't believe this is still going, and did you say that the infected patients are possibly zombies? If that's true, that adds more fuel to the fire. Everyone, if you are in Norfolk, please shelter in place at this time, as like what Aaron said, we might be in for a rough and long day. This is ABC 13 News, with a breaking story. We will now switch you to regular programming.
The following message is transmitted at the request of the Norfolk Police Department. An unusual and dangerous situation is currently taking place in the city of Norfolk. Residents of the city of Norfolk, lock all your doors and windows immediately. The 911 telephone system is currently being overwhelmed with multiple 911 calls, coming and stating that random, violent, and gruesome attacks from feral and deranged individuals have been reported in the city of Norfolk and surrounding areas. In addition, there have been many reports of cannibalism and mutilation of victims, with most of these cases being bites, scratches, and beatings. It is unknown why these attacks are occurring, but it is believed that the individuals who are causing these attacks are infected with the virus that has been spreading throughout the city of Norfolk. The victims have been seen brutally mutilated, as they have been eaten alive or beaten to death, with sections of their flesh torn off their bodies. The individuals also look grotesque looking, as they were seen with a rotting body and pale skin, and are oblivious to anything around them. They were also been seen making very strange noises, vomiting blood, and bleeding profusely. All residents of the city of Norfolk are strongly advised to remain indoors with all your windows and doors locked. Do not approach these attackers, as it is unknown what their nature of current intentions are at this time, and they could possibly mutilate you and beat you to death. If one or more of these attackers enter your home, use armed protection by all means. This includes deadly force. If you believe that you or one of your family members is infected, enter a quarantine that lasts for at least 7 to 10 days, as it is likely that all hospital beds in every single hospital across the city of Norfolk and surrounding areas are full, are not accepting any more patients. If you see anyone in your household experiencing violent or aggressive behavior, isolate them in a separate room immediately, or report them to the police. Tune into local media outlets for more information on this dangerous situation. Civil danger for the city of Norfolk and surrounding areas. The following message is transmitted at the request of the Norfolk Police Department. At approximately 1:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, it has been confirmed that the attackers causing chaos across the city of Norfolk are in fact zombies. It also has been confirmed that people who were infected with this virus, which is called Z-66XR, have died, and 5 minutes later, have reanimated into zombie-like creatures. These creatures are brutally attacking and mutilating anyone that they see in their path, and in very gruesome ways. You may identify these zombies by having the following characteristics and traits: slow moving when walking around, but can sprint at a very quick pace when chasing prey, poor eyesight, white eyes and pupils, wearing torn clothes, has a rotting body, pale skin, has extreme strength, makes multiple sounds such as screeching, groaning, moaning, growling, hissing, or roaring, resilience to conventional weaponry, including gunfire, has an extremely strong grip that's inescapable, an ability to communicate, being covered with blood, and having bites, scratch marks, or sections of flesh torn off of their bodies. These creatures have been reported to cannibalize their victims, and have been seen gruesomely tearing their victims apart and eating away their bodies while multiple eyewitnesses watch in horror. In addition, victims who have been attacked and mutilated by these zombies have fallen into a coma, then 5 minutes later, have turned into zombies themselves, and have become feral, violent, and deranged like their attackers. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation, as people are being eaten alive by these zombies, and are emotionless and show no mercy to anyone whatsoever. These creatures also has extreme sensitive hearing and are also sensitive to light, as most of these attacks have been caused by people shining bright lights at them or making unnecessary loud noises. The only way you can kill these creatures is by using a gun, sword, knife, or a baseball bat and target the brain. If you are bitten by these creatures, you will die in 5 minutes later, and reanimate into one of these creatures yourself. There is no other way of preventing this from happening. If you are bitten, commit suicide immediately as this is the only way out of becoming one of these zombies. This will save the lives of others, or your family members around you, as you will not be a threat to them. All residents of the city of Norfolk are strongly advised to seek shelter immediately. Lock and barricade all windows and doors with heavy objects to prevent these zombies from entering your home. Turn off all lights, and tune in your electronic devices at a low volume and brightness to prevent attracting these creatures. If one or more of these zombies enter your home, use armed protection by all means. This includes lethal force. Do not approach these creatures as they are extremely dangerous. They will absolutely cannibalize and eat you alive, and you will become one of these creatures yourself. Gather essential supplies for your shelter, such as non-perishable food, water, clothing, medical supplies, a flashlight, a first aid kit, a fully charged cell phone chargers, toiletries, important documents, and a battery-powered radio at a very low volume and the backlight turned off, that will last you and your family for the duration of this emergency. Do not make any unnecessary loud noises, as this may attract dozens, if not hundreds of zombies into your shelter. Please stay silent during this situation, as this lowers your risk to being eaten alive and turning into these zombies. Please stay tuned into this station for more information on this deadly situation.
This is ABC 13 News, with yet another breaking story coming out of the city or Norfolk. The situation with this virus has completely escalated ever since it being originated, but this time, we have an even bigger issue in our hands. We now have reports of people who are infected with this virus, which is named Z-66XR, dead, then reanimated into zombie-like creatures. These zombies are terrorizing and causing chaos throughout the city of Norfolk. We have received reports of cannibalism and mutilation of victims who were attacked by these creatures, with most of these cases being bites, scratches, and beatings. You may identify these zombies by having the following characteristics: slow moving when walking around, but can sprint at a very quick pace when chasing prey, poor eyesight, white eyes and pupils, wearing torn clothes, a rotting body, pale skin, has extreme strength, making sounds such as screeching, groaning, moaning, growling, hissing, or roaring, resilience to conventional weaponry, including gunfire, has an extremely strong grip that is inescapable, inability to communicate, being covered with blood, and having bites, scratch marks, or sections of flesh torn off their bodies. Zombies may have been famous in movies, but all of a sudden, it has become a reality. Back live on the air is my correspondent, Aaron. Aaron, are you still there?
I'm still here in downtown Norfolk, and things have really hit rock bottom. These zombies have been viciously attacking random victims in very gruesome ways, and show no mercy to anyone. I'm literally in a scene of The Walking Dead. I can't believe this is real. Zombies have been famous in so many movies, but I never expected this to be in real life. There's zombies everywhere. There are currently thousands of zombies in Norfolk right now. All residents of the city of Norfolk are strongly advised to seek shelter immediately. Do not, in any circumstances, approach these creatures as they are extremely dangerous. They will attack and kill anyone on sight. Do not make any noise or shine bright lights, as they are extremely sensitive to noise and light. Barricade all windows and doors from the inside with heavy furniture to prevent these creatures from entering your home. If you are bitten by these creatures, commit suicide immediately, as this is the only way out of becoming one of these creatures. Oh my god. There are multiple zombies heading after me. I need to run and get out of here now.
And I heard, as it were, the noise of thunder, one of the four beasts saying, "Come and see." And I saw, and behold, a white horse.
There's a man going round taking names, and he decides who to free and who to blame. Everybody won't be treated all the same. There'll be a golden ladder reaching down when the man comes around. The hairs on your arm will stand up at the terror in each sip and in each sup. Will you partake of that last offered cup, or disappear into the potter's ground when the man...
Civil danger for the entire state of Virginia. The following message is transmitted at the request of the Virginia State Police. The situation with Z-66XR and the zombies that originated in the city of Norfolk has escalated. As of 3:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, the virus and the zombies have been reported in many cities outside the city of Norfolk. These cities include Richmond, Leesburg, Blacksburg, Herndon, Christiansburg, Culpeper, Vienna, Virginia Beach, and Arlington. Approximately 100,000 cases of Z-66XR and 30,000 deaths, with almost all of them turning into zombies, have been reported. These zombies are currently attacking innocent civilians indiscriminately, and show no mercy to anyone whatsoever. You may identify these creatures by having the following characteristics and traits: slow moving when walking around, but can sprint at a quick pace when chasing prey, poor eyesight, white eyes and pupils, wears torn clothes, has a rotting body, pale skin, has extreme strength and a strong grip that is inescapable, making sounds such as screeching, moaning, groaning, growling, hissing, or roaring, resilience to physical harm, including gunfire, inability to communicate with surrounding, being covered with blood, and has bites, scratch marks, or sections of flesh torn off of their bodies. These zombies attack humans in very disturbing ways. The military is currently being dispatched to deal with this situation. It is expected that the virus and the zombies will spread throughout more states within the next coming hours. At this time, all residents of the state of Virginia are strongly advised to remain in your homes with all windows and doors locked. Do not approach these creatures, as it will result in almost certain death and you becoming one of these creatures yourself. Turn off all power in your home, as these creatures are very attracted to light. Please make sure all volume on your electronic devices is at the lowest possible, as these zombies are extremely sensitive to noise and will attack anyone who's making noise. Shelter in place in an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building and stay away from windows. Take essential supplies for your shelter, such as non-perishable food, water, clothing, medical supplies, a first aid kit, a fully charged cell phone, phone chargers, toiletries, important documents, and a battery-powered radio at a very low volume. Please stay silent during this situation, as this lowers your risk of being eaten alive by the undead. Stay tuned to this station for more information on this deadly situation.
This is ABCA News, with a breaking story throughout the entire state of Virginia. The virus, which is named Z-66NR, has spread to more cities outside of Norfolk. These cities include Richmond, Leesburg, Blacksburg, Christiansburg, Culpeper, Vienna, Herndon, Arlington, and Virginia Beach. There have also been reports of attacks by zombies in these cities previously mentioned, and these zombies are connected with the virus that has originated in the city of Norfolk. These zombies are feral, deranged, and vicious monsters who are attacking the human race. This virus has also spread at an insanely increasing rate, and is so contagious, deadly, and out of control. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has stated that chances of a pandemic involved with this virus is very high. Over the past 2 days, the virus has continued to get worse, and will keep getting worse as time goes on, and the mutations of the virus is the cause of the transformations into these zombies. It is expected that the virus in zombies will be in more states within the next coming hours. We currently have no reporter on the scene as it is extremely dangerous right now. All residents of Virginia, no matter where you live, are strongly advised to seek shelter now, and avoid going outside for any reason, as this puts you at risk of contracting the virus and turning into these creatures. This is ABCA News, with a breaking story, and we'll switch to your regular programming.
Civil danger for the entire southeastern United States. The following message is transmitted at the request of the Federal Emergency Management Agency. The situation with the virus and zombies in the state of Virginia has continued to worsen and has spread to more states outside of Virginia. These states include West Virginia, North Carolina, South Carolina, Delaware, Maryland, Georgia, and Florida. These zombies are currently attacking the human race by the means of cannibalism and mutilation. This situation is compounded with Z-66XR, which is the cause of these transformations to these zombies. This virus is continuing to spread at a high rate, and cases are continuing to skyrocket. Approximately 1 million cases of this virus and 400,000 deaths, with almost all of them transformed into zombies, have been reported. The military is currently having a difficult time killing all of these creatures, as they continue to multiply and outnumber their armies. It is expected that the virus and zombies will spread throughout the entire United States within the next coming hours. At this time, all residents of the states previously mentioned are strongly advised to not go outside for any reason. Doing so will put your life in extreme danger. Shelter in place in an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building and avoid windows, doors, and outside walls. Do not make any sudden noise. Doing so will result in dozens, if not hundreds, of zombies attracted to your shelter. Please stay tuned to this station for more information on this dangerous situation.
This is CNN Breaking News.
This is CNN News, and we have a special report from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. The CDC has states that this virus, which is named Z-66XR, is containable with an effective vaccine. However, the CDC is not guaranteeing that the vaccine will be delivered in time, as this virus has spread so quickly for the past few days. The virus that has originated from Norfolk has now been reported in the northeastern and midwestern United States. There is approximately 5 million cases and 1.5 million deaths, with almost all of them turning into zombies. The CDC cannot stress enough that you must follow proper health guidelines to prevent contracting this virus. However, that is also not even guaranteed, as zombies are also present, and you will most likely have to be in your shelter for a long, long time, or until this situation is under control. This virus also has a 100% infection rate, and you can contract this virus in many other ways, mostly it being airborne and able to spread from person to person. We currently have a reporter in California at this time, Zoe. Zoe, are you there?
I'm here in downtown Los Angeles in California at this time, where business as usual at this time. There are no cases of this virus around the southwestern and northwestern United States. However, it is possible that we might end up in the same situation as it is in the northeastern and southeastern United States, as this virus is continuing to spread rapidly, and is showing no signs of stopping whatsoever. Like you said, the CDC has stated that this virus is containable with an effective vaccine, however, that is not guaranteed. The CDC has also stated that this virus is likely going to cause a pandemic, and it can be reported in other countries outside of the United States, most likely in Canada and Mexico. What's even worse is that zombies are present, which does the same actions as the virus, spreading non-stop. I have a feeling this won't get any better anytime soon, as it is unlikely that the vaccine will be delivered in time due to this virus being so contagious, deadly, and out of control. Best case scenario is that it will take at least a year or two to develop a vaccine, but this virus is on pace to spread throughout the entire globe in under a year. But as long as people do proper health guidelines to prevent the spread, it will be an easier process. Back over to you, Samantha.
Thank you, Zoe. We also have a spokesperson from the CDC headquarters on the phone at this time. How is it going so far with the vaccine?
Thank you for asking. Right now, it is not looking too good, as this virus is on pace to where we don't have enough time to deliver the vaccine. This process will take at least a year or two, but according to Z-66XR, due to it spreading at such an increasing rate we have never seen before, and zombies being connected to the virus, it is not guaranteed that we will deliver the vaccine in time. However, we are doing the best that we can to finish this process as soon as possible to save the planet from a potential world-ending pandemic and zombie apocalypse. We cannot stress enough that all residents must follow safety health guidelines and instructions to prevent being eaten alive by the undead, as your survival chances with this virus and the zombies are very slim. Back over to you.
Thank you very much. We will try to provide you more information whenever it becomes available. This is CNN News, with a breaking story. We will now switch you to regular scheduled programming.
Thank you.
This is an emergency action notification requested by the White House. All EAS participants will follow activations procedures in the EAS Operating Handbook for a National Level Emergency. The President of the United States or one of his representatives will shortly deliver a message over the emergency alert system. Please stand by, please stand by, please stand by. We interrupt our regular programming. This is a national emergency. Important details will follow. This is an emergency action notification. All broadcasts and cable systems shall transmit this emergency action notification message. This station has interrupted its regular programming at the request of the White House to participate in the emergency alert system. During this emergency, most stations will remain on the air providing news and information to the public in assigned areas. This is WIOQ. We will continue to serve the Philadelphia area. If you are not in this local area, tune now into stations providing news and information for your areas. This is the emergency alert system serving the Philadelphia area. Do not use your telephone. The telephone line should be kept open for emergency use. The emergency alert system has been activated. We interrupt our regular programming at the request of the White House. This is the emergency alert system. All normal programming has been discontinued during this emergency. This is WIOQ. We will continue furnishing news, official information and instructions to the Philadelphia area. If you are not in the Philadelphia area, you should tune into stations providing news and information for your area. It is important that you listen carefully to announcements from this station for your local area. The following message is transmitted at the request of the United States government, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, and the Federal Emergency Management Agency. This is not a test. I repeat, this is not a test. Please pay close attention to this alert, as this pertains to an ongoing national crisis. At approximately 9 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, cases of Z-66XR and zombies that were originated in Norfolk, Virginia, have now been reported in all 50 states of the United States, including Alaska and Hawaii. These zombies are currently attacking the human race by the means of cannibalism and mutilation. In addition, this is connected to the virus that has been spreading throughout the entire country for the past few days. This virus has spread at an insanely fast rate, due to it being 100% infectious, including it being contagious, deadly, and out of control. What adds more fuel to the fire is that people who are infected with the virus dies in 5 minutes, then another 5 minutes later, have reanimated into zombie-like creatures, and have become feral, deranged and show homicidal aggression to any living human, and show no mercy whatsoever. These zombies have been seen brutally attacking victims in several disturbing ways. These creatures have a strong grip that is inescapable, and will gruesomely tear their victims apart and eat away their bodies as multiple eyewitnesses watch in horror. People who have been attacked by these zombies have fallen into a coma, then 5 minutes later, they will wake up from the dead and become violent and deranged like their attackers. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation, as the United States population is plummeting within a matter of hours. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention is trying their hardest to deliver a vaccine, but will not be guaranteed to be delivered in time due to this virus continuing to spread at a fast rate as time goes on. The CDC has also stated that this virus will likely cause a pandemic, and cases of the virus and reanimations into zombies will be reported in other countries of the world. There are approximately 50 million cases of Z-66XR and 15 million deaths, with almost all of them turning into zombies being reported in the United States at this time. At this time, all residents of the United States are strongly advised to shelter in place. Shelter in an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building with only a few windows or entrances to the outside world. Take essential supplies for your shelter, such as non-perishable food, water, clothing, medical supplies, a flashlight, a first aid kit, a fully charged cell phone, phone chargers, toiletries, important documents, and a battery-powered radio at a very low volume and the backlight turned off. Do not approach these creatures as they are extremely dangerous. They will absolutely mutilate and cannibalize anyone that they see in their path. The President of the United States is about to make an announcement regarding this situation, and will be transmitted through the emergency alert system. Please stand by for this message. The President of the United States has been moved into an undisclosed location at this time. Please stand by for a message from the President, or one of his representatives.
Hello, my fellow citizens of the United States. This is something we thought would never come to reality. The Walking Dead has officially come to reality. Reports of cases of Z-66XR and reanimations into zombies have been reported in every single state of the United States, including Alaska and Hawaii. These creatures attack and kill anyone that they see in their path in many disturbing ways, and show no mercy whatsoever. You may identify these zombies by having the following characteristics and traits: slow moving when walking around, but can sprint at a very quick pace when chasing prey, poor eyesight, wears torn clothes, a rotting body, pale skin, wide eyes and pupils, has a strong, tight, and inescapable grip, makes sounds such as screeching, moaning, growling, hissing, or roaring, resilience to physical harm, including gunfire, inability to communicate with surrounding, being covered with blood, and have bites, scratches, or sections of flesh torn off their bodies. These zombies have been seen tearing their victims apart and eating away their bodies as multiple eyewitnesses watch in fear. Those who have been reported to be attacked by these zombies have died, then 5 minutes later, have reanimated and become feral and deranged like their attackers. At this time, my fellow Americans, no matter where you live, are strongly advised to shelter in place. Shelter in an interior room on the lowest floor of a sturdy building. Avoid windows, doors, and outside walls. Close and lock all windows and doors, turn off all lights, close all fireplace dampers, and seal all cracks on doors and windows with tape or damp towels. Do not go outside, as this puts you at risk for being eaten alive. Do not make any noise, as these creatures smell fear, and will attack anyone who makes noise or shine bright lights. America may be experiencing an unprecedented crisis, but as a country, we will kill all these zombies and will end this total nightmare. We have no reason to fall to these zombies, as we are the strongest country in the world. Thank you for listening to this message, and as always, God bless America.
That was a message from the President of the United States. This concludes the final activation of the emergency alert system. However, regular programming has been suspended indefinitely until this crisis has ended.
Event type is contagious disease, for the city of Toronto, Canada. This message is transmitted at the request of the Toronto Health Department. Toronto is currently experiencing cases of a contagious and deadly virus, which was originated in the United States. There is an estimated 250 cases of this virus in Toronto right now. Symptoms of this disease include high fever, chills, muscle aches, coughing or vomiting blood, congestion, fatigue, headache, anxiety, insomnia, seizures, psychosis, dementia, necrosis, coma, violent or aggressive behavior, and most likely death. The incubation period is no more than 5 hours after exposure. Transmission of this virus is from the air and person to person. It is possible that Toronto could deal with the same situation as it is in the United States right now, which is in fact, undead people. All residents of Toronto are advised to shelter in place for the foreseeable future, as cases of this virus can skyrocket and spread at a fast rate, just like it did in the United States. Please follow proper health guidelines to prevent the spread of this virus. These include washing your hands with soap and warm water for at least 20 seconds after touching your eyes or mouth, or after going to the bathroom, clean surfaces after use, avoid large gatherings, avoid physical contact with others, and wear facial coverings, mostly masks. Please stay tuned for more information on this potentially dangerous situation.
Eventipis contagio disease, for the province of Toronto, Canada. This message is transmitted at the request of the Toronto Health Department. Toronto is currently experiencing cases of a contagio and the deadly virus, which were originated in the United States. The recent estimated 250 cases of this virus in Toronto right now. Symptoms of this disease include high fever, chills, musclash, coughing or vomiting blood, congestion, fatigue, headache, anxiety, insomnia, seizure, psychosis, dementia, necrosis, coma, viol or aggressive behavior, and the most likely death. The incubation period is no more than 5 hours after exposure. Transmission of this virus is from the air and person to person. It is possible that Toronto could deal with the same situation it is in the United States right now, which is in fact, un des happy people. All residents of Toronto are advised to shelter in place for the foreseeable future. A case of this virus can skyrocket and spread at a faster rate, just like it's in the United States. Please follow appropriate health guidelines to prevent the spread of this virus. Those include washing your hands with soap and warm water for at least 20 seconds, after touching your eyes or mouth, or after going to the bathroom, clean surface after use, avoir large gathering, avoir physical contact with others, and wear facial covering, mostly mask. Please stay tuned for more information on this potentially dangerous situation.
Event type is civil emergency, for the city of Toronto, Canada. This message is transmitted at the request of the Toronto Police Department. An extremely dangerous situation is currently taking place in Toronto. Many hospitals across the city of Toronto and surrounding areas have experienced patients showing violent and even homicidal aggression and brutally attacking doctors inside the hospital. In addition, this virus has spread quickly, and is now reported in Mississauga, Vaughan, Markham, Pickering, and Brampton. There are now reported 15,000 cases of this virus, which is named Z-66XR, and 5,000 deaths reported in the city of Toronto and surrounding areas. All hospital beds are full at this time, and are not letting anyone in. Most if not all hospitals are currently experiencing these attacks from the infected patients. These individuals were also seen roaming around the city, and were randomly attacking the uninfected. These people were seen grotesque looking, as others were disgusted by their looks. They were seen vomiting blood and has pale skin and a rotting body. It is possible that these people are, in fact, undead, but this cannot be confirmed at this time. All residents of Toronto and surrounding cities are advised to shelter in an interior room away from windows and any entrances to the outside world. You are not allowed to go outside for any reason, as this puts you at risk for contracting the virus. All non-essential businesses, including several essential businesses, will be closed until further notice, or until this situation is under control. It is expected that more cases of this virus will be in more provinces outside of Toronto as time goes on. Please stay tuned to this station for more information whenever it becomes available.
Eventipis civil emergency, for the city of Toronto, Canada. This message is transmitted at the request of the Toronto Police Department. An extremely dangerous situation is currently taking place in Toronto. Many hospitals across the city of Toronto and the surrounding area have experienced patients showing violent and even homicidal aggression and brutally attacking doctors inside the hospital. In addition, this virus has spread quickly, and is now reported in Mississauga, Vaughan, Markham, Pickering, and the Branton. There are now reported 15,000 cases of this virus, which is named Z-66R, and the same idiot reported in the city of Toronto and the surrounding area. All hospital beds are full at this time, and are not letting anyone in. Most if not all hospitals are currently experiencing those attacks from the infected patients. Those individuals were also seen roaming around the city, and they were randomly attacking the uninfected. Those people were seen grotesque looking, out they were disgusted by their look. They were seen vomiting blood and a pale skin and a rotting body. It is possible that those people are, in fact, undead, but this cannot be confirmed at this time. All residents of Toronto and the surrounding city are advised to shelter in an interior room away from windows and any entrance to the outside world. You are not allowed to go outside for any reason, as you are at risk for contracting the virus. All non-essential business, including several essential business, will be closed until further notice, or until this situation is under control. It is expected that more cases of this virus will be in more provinces outside of Toronto as time goes on. Please stay tuned to this station for more information when it becomes available.
Event type is civil danger, for the entire province of Ontario. This message is transmitted at the request of the Ontario Police. It has been confirmed that the attackers who have been causing chaos throughout Toronto and surrounding areas in the province of Ontario are in fact, undead. People who have been infected with Z-66XR, have died, then 5 minutes later, have reanimated into zombies. These zombies are attacking any living human that they see, and show no mercy whatsoever. You can easily identify these zombies by having the following characteristics and traits: slow moving when walking around, but can sprint at a quick pace when chasing prey, poor eyesight, white eyes and pupils, wearing torn clothing, a rotting body, pale skin, making sounds such as screeching, moaning, groaning, growling, hissing, or roaring, resilience to physical harm, including gunfire, a strong grip that is inescapable, inability to communicate with surrounding, being covered with blood, and having bites, scratches, or sections of flesh torn off of their bodies. These zombies attack humans in very disturbing ways. Once a zombie gets a strong grip at you, there is no escape, and you will brutally be torn apart and eaten alive by these zombies. People who have been attacked by these zombies have fallen into a coma and died, then 5 minutes later, have woken up from the dead and will become violent, feral, and deranged like their attackers. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation as people are being eaten alive and attacked indiscriminately by these creatures, and they'll absolutely cannibalize and mutilate their victims. All residents of Ontario are strongly advised to remain in your homes with all of your windows and doors locked and barricaded with heavy furniture. Do not approach these zombies as they are considered extremely dangerous. They will brutally tear you apart and eat you away, and you will become a zombie yourself. Grab essential supplies for your shelter that will last you and your family for the duration of this emergency. The Canadian military will be dispatched to try to kill all of these zombies. This situation is similar to what is going on in the United States with the virus and zombies spreading at a fast rate. The United States is already collapsing as zombies have taken over the entire country, and will likely take over the entire country of Canada. It is highly advised you follow proper health guidelines and follow instructions by the Canadian government to ensure your survival. Do not go outside for any reason. Doing so will likely result in you contracting the virus and becoming one of these zombies, or being eaten alive by the undead. Please stay tuned to this station for more information on this extremely dangerous situation.
Thank you.
National Information Center statement. The following message is transmitted at the request of the United States government and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. More cases of Z-66XR and zombies have been reported in more countries outside of the United States. Cases of this virus has been completely skyrocketed to exponential levels and has spread so quickly over the past month and a half due to it being so contagious, deadly, and out of control. There is an estimated 150 million cases of Z-66XR and 50 million deaths, with almost all of them turning into zombies. This virus has also been reported in the entire country of Canada and some parts of Mexico. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention are continuing to work on developing an effective vaccine. It is likely that more cases of the virus and reports of zombie attacks will be reported in more countries across the globe as time goes on. The military in the United States and Canada are currently dispatched to kill all of the creatures. At this time, all residents, if you're still alive during this situation, are strongly advised to remain in your shelters at this time. Tune into local media outlets for more information on this situation. This is an emergency action notification requested by the White House. All EAS participants will follow activations procedures in the EAS Operating Handbook for a National Level Emergency. The President of the United States or one of his representatives will shortly deliver a message over the emergency alert system. Please stand by. Please stand by. Please stand by. We interrupt our regular programming. This is a global emergency. Important details will follow. The following message is transmitted at the request of the United States government, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, and the Federal Emergency Management Agency. This is not a test. I repeat, this is not a test. Please do not turn off your radio or television, as this pertains to an ongoing global crisis. Cases of Z-66XR in zombies have been reported in multiple countries across the globe. These include Mexico, United Kingdom, Australia, Russia, China, North and South Korea, Indonesia, and Japan. These creatures are attacking the human race by the means of a coordinated effort of cannibalism and mutilation. It is expected that the zombies in Z-66XR will be reported in all countries of the world as time goes on. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has stated that this virus outbreak is now a pandemic. Approximately 500 million cases of Z-66XR and 150 million deaths, with almost all of them turning into zombies, have been reported worldwide, and this number will continue to skyrocket as time goes on. The CDC has also stated that the chance of delivering a vaccine in time is very slim, as this virus has spread so quickly for the past 1.5 months. What adds more fuel to the fire is that zombies are connected with the virus. You may easily identify the zombies by having the following characteristics and traits: slow moving when walking around, but can sprint at a very quick pace when chasing prey, poor eyesight, white eyes and pupils, extreme strength, wearing torn clothing, a rotting body, pale skin, makes multiple sounds such as screeching, moaning, groaning, growling, hissing, or roaring, resilience to any physical harm, including gunfire, a strong, tight, and inescapable grip, inability to communicate with surrounding, vomiting blood and bleeding profusely, and have bites, scratches, and sections of flesh torn off of their bodies. These creatures attack any living human in several disturbing ways, most cases being scratching, biting, or beating. Victims have been seen brutally mauled, as they have been beaten to death, torn apart, and eaten alive by these zombies. Militaries around the world are being dispatched to kill all of these creatures. At this time, all residents, no matter where you live, are strongly advised to shelter in place immediately. Barricade all windows and doors to prevent these creatures from entering your home. If one or more of these creatures enter your home, use armed protection by any means. This includes deadly force. Turn off all power, as these creatures are extremely sensitive to light. Make sure all electronic devices are at the lowest level possible, as these zombies are extremely sensitive to noise. Take essential supplies for your shelter, such as non-perishable food, water, clothing, medical supplies, a first aid kit, a fully charged cell phone, phone chargers, toiletries, important documents, and a battery-powered radio at a very low volume and the backlight turned off. Do not go outside for any reason. Doing so will put you at risk for contracting the virus and turning into one of these creatures, or can result in you being eaten alive by the undead. Do not make any unnecessary noises, as this will result in dozens, if not hundreds, of zombies attracted to your shelter. Tune into local media outlets for more information on this extremely dangerous situation.
Event type is national emergency for the entire country of Canada. This message is transmitted at the request of the Canadian government. This is not a test. I repeat, this is not a test. A national state of emergency has been declared for the entire country of Canada. At approximately 1:30 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time, cases of the virus, which is named Z-66XR, have been reported in the entire country of Canada. This has spread so quickly for the past month. What's even worse is that zombies are present and are connected to the virus that has been spreading throughout most of the planet. There are approximately 500 million cases of Z-66XR and 150 million deaths, with almost all of them turning into zombies. You can easily identify a zombie by having the following characteristics and traits: slow moving when walking around, but can sprint at a very quick pace when chasing prey, poor eyesight, white eyes and pupils, wearing torn clothing, a rotting body, pale skin, extreme strength, making sounds such as screeching, moaning, groaning, growling, hissing, or roaring, resilience to any conventional weaponry if not hit in the head. This includes gunfire, a strong, tight, an inescapable grip, inability to communicate with surrounding, being covered with blood, and having bites, scratches, or sections of flesh torn off their bodies. These zombies attack any living human in very disturbing ways, and show no mercy to anyone. Once a zombie gets a strong grip at you, there is no escape, and you will be brutally torn apart and eaten away by these creatures. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation, as people are being eaten alive and attacked indiscriminately by these creatures. All residents of Canada, no matter where you live, are strongly advised to shelter in place for the foreseeable future. Barricade all windows and doors with heavy furniture to prevent these zombies from entering your home. Turn off all power, as these creatures are sensitive to light. Do not make any unnecessary noises, as the zombies are also extremely sensitive to noise. Grab essential supplies that will last you and your family for the duration of this emergency. Stay tuned to this station for more information on this dangerous situation.
This is an emergency broadcast from the BBC. Information about a virus spreading through the entire country of UK has been received. About 25 minutes ago, the UK Department of Health and Social Care has detected a virus spreading throughout the entire country. In addition, this virus has transformed the infected into zombie-like creatures. People who are infected with the virus, which is named Z-66XR, have died, then minutes later, have reanimated into zombies. These creatures are attacking any uninfected people, and they show no mercy to anyone whatsoever. They attack humans in very disturbing ways, most cases being biting, scratching, or beating. Victims have been seen brutally eaten alive, as sections of flesh have been ripped off their bodies. Victims who have been attacked by these creatures have fallen into a coma, then minutes later, have reanimated into a zombie themselves, and show the same characteristics like their attackers. This is not only happening in the UK, but other countries such as the United States and Canada are dealing with the same situation. There are approximately 500 million cases of Z-66XR and 150 million deaths, with almost all of them turning into zombies, being reported worldwide. The World Health Organization has stated that this virus is now a pandemic, as other countries outside of the United States, where the virus originated at, are now experiencing cases of the virus and the zombies. This is an extremely dangerous and life-threatening situation, as people are being eaten alive. At this time, all residents of the UK, no matter where you live, are advised to stay in your homes with all of your windows and doors barricaded, to prevent these zombies from entering your home. Turn off all power, and do not make any unnecessary noises, as these zombies are extremely sensitive to noise and light. Do not, in any circumstances, go outside, as this will result in you contracting the virus and turning into one of these zombies, or possibly being eaten alive by them. Grab essential supplies that will last you and your family for the duration of this emergency. Stay tuned for more information on this deadly situation. Please stand by for a broadcast from the National Emergency Warning System. Please stand by for a broadcast from the National Emergency Warning System.
This is an emergency warning. Information about the virus spreading throughout the planet has been received. About 25 minutes ago, the Australia Department of Health has detected a new virus, which is named Z-66XR. This virus was originated from the United States, but has spread so quickly for the past month that now it's being reported not only here in Australia, but in Canada and the UK. What's even worse is that zombies are connected to the virus, and they've also been reported in any areas that the virus is present in, including our continent, Australia. People who contract Z-66XR will face symptoms, then will die, and reanimate into these creatures. These zombies are attacking the human race.
You can easily identify a zombie because of its following characteristics and traits: slow moving when walking around, but can sprint at a very quick pace when chasing prey, poor eyesight, white eyes and pupils, wearing torn clothing, a rotting body, extreme strength, makes multiple sounds like screeching, moaning, groaning, growling, hissing, or roaring, are resilient to any conventional weaponry, including gunfire, a strong grit that is inescapable, inability to communicate, being covered with blood, and have bites, scratches, or sections of flesh torn off their bodies. These creatures attack a human in disturbing ways, most cases being biting, scratching, or beating. Once a zombie gets a grip on you, you can't escape their wrath, and will brutally cannibalize you and eat you alive. Victims have been seen beaten to death, as they've been brutally torn apart and had their flesh torn off of their body. This is a life-threatening situation for the entire continent of Australia. The World Health Organization has also stated that this virus is officially a pandemic, as it has spread through other countries outside of the country the virus originated in. At this time, all residents of Australia, no matter where you live, are strongly advised to stay in your homes. Close and lock all windows and doors to prevent these zombies from entering your home. Do not approach these zombies, as this will likely result in certain death. Turn off all power and tune into your radios at a very low volume, as these creatures are extremely sensitive to noise and light, and most of the attacks from these zombies were from people shining bright lights at them or make loud noises. Do not make any unnecessary noises, as this will result in dozens of zombies attracted to your shelter. Grab food, water, medical supplies and clothing that will last you and your family for the duration of this emergency. Stay tuned to this station for more information on this extremely dangerous situation.
This is CNN Breaking News.
This is CNN News, with a breaking story coming out of most of the world. The World Health Organization has stated that Z-66XR is officially a pandemic. This virus is now reported in Canada, the UK, Australia, and many other countries across the planet. There is an estimated 500 million cases of this virus and 150 million deaths, with almost all of them turning into zombies being reported worldwide. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention is having a difficult time developing an effective vaccine, as this virus is continuing to spread so quickly for the past month that chances of a vaccine being delivered in time is very slim. However, best case scenario is that it will take several months to a year to develop an effective vaccine and deliver it to the world to save the lives of the public. This situation has escalated dramatically, and it keeps getting worse, and will continue to get worse as time goes on. The human population is beginning to plummet as the virus and zombies are starting to take over the entire planet. It is very surprising that most news headquarters around the United States is still running, despite the country being close to a barren wasteland. We are currently trying our best to keep update with the situation while staying low, to prevent attracting zombies to our headquarters. Right now, on the phone, we have a spokesperson from the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. Tell me, how are things going with the vaccine?
Thank you for asking once again. We are currently working day and night to develop an effective vaccine for Z-66XR to save the human race from going extinct due to this situation. However, human extinction cannot be ruled out at this time, as this virus and the zombies will not stop spreading until every human being is infected or consumed. Right now, it is not looking great as this virus is now being reported in many other countries outside of the United States. The pressure is currently on us to prevent a world-ending zombie apocalypse. Best case scenario, like you said, is that this will take at least several months to years to develop an effective vaccine and deliver it to the planet to save the people who are left alive. But right now, cases of this virus and transformations into zombies are skyrocketing to exponential levels, and will continue to skyrocket as time goes on. Human population is plummeting as the zombies are taking over the world. If we cannot deliver the vaccine in time, the only option for residents who are still alive is suicide. But we'll be continuing to work day and night to finish the process, and we'll do our best to deliver it in time. Back over to you.
Thank you very much. Best we can do is pray that the vaccine will be delivered in time. This is CNN News. However, regular programming is suspended at this time, until this crisis has ended.
This is an emergency action termination. The vaccine, which the CDC has been working on for the past year, has been delivered and has been deemed effective for Z-66XR. Approximately 98% of the virus is contained, and no more cases are being reported worldwide at this time. In addition, the zombies that have been causing chaos throughout the entire planet have been killed by militaries around the world. They have found a way to kill all of these zombies quicker, which was by bombing them. As the creatures were outnumbering the entire military, there is no threat to the planet at this time. However, there is massive damage to the entire world. At this time, all residents, if you're still alive, may exit your shelters at this time. The National Guard is currently unavailable to rescue people dealing with emergencies due to extremely hazardous road conditions. If your home or shelter has been destroyed due to being bombed, call 911. And the National Guard will try their best to take you to the nearest military base. All broadcasts and cable systems will now be handed to state and local officials. This concludes the final activation of the emergency alert system. Regular programming will now resume. Your government thanks you for your cooperation during this emergency.
Event type is civil emergency, for the entire country of Canada. This message is transmitted at the request of the Canadian government. The vaccine, which was being developed by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention for the last year, has been finally delivered, and was deemed effective for the virus. There are no more cases of this virus being reported at this time. In addition, the zombies that have been causing chaos throughout the entire planet, have been killed by militaries around the world by bombing them. There is no more threat to the entire country of Canada and other countries at this time. I repeat, there is no more threat. All residents, you may exit your shelters at this time. If your home has been destroyed due to being bombed, go to any other shelters available. Regular programming will now resume at this time. The Canadian government would like to thank you for your cooperation during this crisis.
Eventipis civil emergency. For the entire country of Canada. This message is transmitted at the request of the Canadian government. The vaccine, which was being developed by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention for the last year, has been finally delivered, and was deemed effective for the virus. There are no more cases of this virus being reported at this time. In addition, the zombie that have been causing chaos through the entire planet have been killed by military around the world by bombing them. There is no more threat to the entire country of Canada and other country at this time. Europea, there is no more threat. Allez resident, you may exit your shelter at this time. If your room has been destroyed due to being bombed, go to any other shelter available. Regular programming will now resume at this time. The Canadian government would like to thank you for your cooperation during this crisis.
Please stand by for an emergency broadcast by the BBC. This is an emergency broadcast from the BBC. Information about the virus has been received. It has been confirmed that the vaccine for Z-66XR, which was being developed by the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention, has been delivered and has been deemed effective for the virus. There are no more cases of the virus being reported worldwide at this time. In addition, the zombies that have been causing chaos throughout the entire country of UK have also been killed by the military by bombing them. There is no threat to the UK at this time. All residents, you may exit your shelters at this time. There is no more threat. If your home or shelter has been destroyed due to being bombed, go to any other shelters available. The government of the UK would like to thank you for your cooperation during this emergency.
Please stand by for a message from the National Emergency Warning System. This is an emergency warning. Information about the virus has been received. It has been confirmed that the vaccine, which the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention have been working on for the past year, has finally been delivered and is deemed effective for Z-66XR. The virus is now 98% contained, and no more cases are being reported worldwide at this time. In addition, the zombies that have been causing chaos and total destruction throughout Australia have all been killed. They were killed by being bombed. There is no more threat for Australia at this time. All residents, you may exit your shelters at this time. There is no more threat. If your home has been damaged or destroyed, go to military bases marked around the area. The Australian government would like to thank you for your cooperation during this crisis.
This is an emergency action notification requested by the White House. All EAS participants will follow activations procedures in the EAS Operating Handbook for a National Level Emergency. The President of the United States or one of his representatives will shortly deliver a message over the emergency alert system. Please stand by. Please stand by. Please stand by. We interrupt our regular programming. This is a global emergency. Important details will follow. The following message is transmitted at the request of the United States government, the Federal Emergency Management Agency, and the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. This is not a test. I repeat, this is not a test. Please do not turn off your radio or television, as this pertains to an ongoing global crisis. Our world is coming to an end. Cases of Z-66XR and zombies have been reported in every single country on planet Earth. These creatures are attacking anyone who is left on the Earth. In addition, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has stated that a vaccine won't be delivered in time due to this virus spreading throughout the entire planet for the past 5 months, and gave no time whatsoever to deliver an effective vaccine. Approximately 75% of the human population has been infected with Z-66XR, or turned into the undead. Our president, along with other world leaders, have turned into zombies, which resulted in government collapse. Planet Earth will become a barren wasteland. The human population is plummeting at a fast rate, resulting in human extinction. At this time, there is absolutely no way to survive this event. There is no cure for Z-66XR, and there's nothing humanity to stop the virus and zombies from spreading further and further. It is only a matter of time that every living organism will be consumed, and there will be no humans left. Militaries around the world have failed to kill all of these creatures, as the amount of zombies multiplied, and have outnumbered and overwhelmed the military. At this time, all residents of the world, if you're still alive, are advised to do the final instructions. Gather with your loved ones, such as family, friends, loved possessions, or pets, and embrace for the end. There is no place to evacuate or seek shelter, as zombies are everywhere and have taken over the entire globe. There is no reason to stay calm, go into complete panic mode, if you want to. Engage in any activity that pleases you. Ask for forgiveness. I have selected a verse of the Bible, to be read on the air, 1 Peter 2, 9. But you are a chosen people, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, God's special possession, that you may declare the praises of him who called you out of darkness into his wonderful light. We will conclude the final activation of the emergency alert system with one last plain of our national anthem. May God be with you all. Oh my God, are those zombies? Yes, they are. Oh God, I must get out of here now.
event type is global emergency, for the entire country of Canada and the rest of the world. This message is transmitted at the request of the Canadian government. At approximately 10 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time, cases of Z-66XR and zombies have been reported in every single country on planet Earth, including Canada. These zombies are attacking any human that is left on the Earth. In addition, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has stated that there will be no effective vaccine for Z-66XR, as there won't be enough time to deliver the vaccine in time, as it has spread so quickly throughout the entire planet for the past 5 months. Approximately 75% of the human population has been infected by Z-66XR, or have turned into these zombies. It is only a matter of time until every human is consumed and turned into a zombie. Militaries around the world have failed to kill these zombies, as they've continued to multiply and have taken over the planet. There is no way to contain this virus, and it is likely that this will be the end of the human race as we know it. All remaining humans on the Earth are advised to do the final instructions, gather with all your loved ones, such as family and friends, and embrace for the end. Do not tell younger children about this event, and be sure they are well-being during these dark times. There is no other option for survival for this event. The only way out of being eaten alive or becoming a zombie is committing suicide. We will conclude the final activation of the Alert Ready system with one last plane of our national anthem. This broadcast will cease transmission at the conclusion of this alert, and all TV and radio stations will be shut down for good. May God be with you all. God bless the true North, strong and free. Oh my God, are those zombies? How did they get in here? I must get out of here now.
This is an emergency broadcast from the BBC. This message is transmitted at the request of the Government of UK. Information about the virus has been received. Cases of Z-66XR and zombies have been reported in every single country on planet Earth, including the UK. These zombies are attacking any human that is left on the Earth. In addition, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has stated that there will be no effective vaccine for Z-66XR, as there won't be enough time to deliver the vaccine in time, as it has spread so quickly throughout the entire planet for the past 5 months. Approximately 75% of the human population has been infected by Z-66XR, or have turned into these zombies. It is only a matter of time until every human is consumed and turned into a zombie. Militaries around the world have failed to kill these zombies, as they've continued to multiply and have taken over the planet. There is no way to contain this virus, and it is likely that this will be the end of the human race as we know it. All remaining humans on the Earth are advised to do the final instructions, gather with all your loved ones, such as family and friends, and embrace for the end. Do not tell younger children about this event, and be sure they are well-being during these dark times. There is no other option for survival for this event. The only way out of being eaten alive or becoming a zombie is committing suicide. We will conclude the final activation of the emergency broadcast system with one last playing of our national anthem. This broadcast will cease transmission at the conclusion of this alert, and all TV and radio stations will be shut down for good. May God be with you all, and God save the Queen. Oh my God, are those zombies? Wow, there's so many of them. I must get out of here now. This is an emergency warning. This message is transmitted at the request of the Government of Australia. Information about the virus has been received. Cases of Z-66XR and zombies have been reported in every single country on planet Earth, including Australia. These zombies are attacking any human that is left on the Earth. In addition, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention has stated that there will be no effective vaccine for Z-66XR, as there won't be enough time to deliver the vaccine in time, as it has spread so quickly throughout the entire planet for the past 5 months. Approximately 75% of the human population has been infected by Z-66XR, or have turned into these zombies. It is only a matter of time until every human is consumed and turned into a zombie. Militaries around the world have failed to kill these zombies, as they've continued to multiply and have taken over the planet. There is no way to contain this virus, and it is likely that this will be the end of the human race as we know it. All remaining humans on the Earth are advised to do the final instructions, gather with all your loved ones, such as family and friends, and embrace for the end. Do not tell younger children about this event, and be sure they well-being during these dark times. There is no other option for survival for this event. The only way out of being eaten alive or becoming a zombie is committing suicide. We will conclude the final activation of the National Emergency Warning System with one last playing of our national anthem. This broadcast will cease transmission at the conclusion of this alert, and all TV and radio stations will be shut down for good. May God be with you all, and God blessed the Commonwealth of Australia. Oh my God, are those zombies? Oh no, they're heading towards me. I must get out of here now.